Hello everyone, welcome to another one of my videos. This video is somewhat resume related, but it's pretty much an update on my channel. So pretty much recently I've noticed that I'm about to hit 200 subscribers, and I really want to hit the milestones very soon because it's a milestone that I really thought it was going to take me at least 5 months to reach there, being actively posting the videos. I don't know, I have really low standards of my videos. I think many people were liking them and stuff like that, but apparently you guys do, and I'm really glad that you guys do. And what I'm planning to do is, if you haven't heard or seen me in my previous live streams, I had the idea of making 100 doing giveaways every 100 subscribers. And what kind of giveaways, I didn't really know how much I wanted to give away and gem wise, and people kept asking for an account giveaway, which I had given up on a lot of my accounts back a year or two ago, so I lost many of them. But after digging some time, I was able to find one account, so I'll be able to give one of those away for a different giveaway. But right now, I'll get more into details. So starting for the 200 subscriber giveaway. So currently, I do have 500 gems, I believe. Oh, where's my main? Here it is. I mean, not gems. 500,000 holy stars. Which is something I want to open in a giveaway. I mean, not in a giveaway. I want to open these stars in a live stream, as well as being able to actually take advantage of the event boss that's out right now for the next 3 days. So I was hoping if I'm able to reach the 200 subscribers by Thursday, which I believe that's the last day, because right now we're on Tuesday. Two more days, then it's Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. On Thursday, on the reset change, that's when the boss leaves, and I lose a chance of using my stars for the gear drops, which is the reason I want to do during this time. At the moment, I believe I'm 189 subscribers at the time that I'm recording this video. So I hope you guys have friends that like to watch this kind of videos, and they like to see the Joker rallies that we've been doing. Or they're really for informational, my videos informational, and help them out to grow as free to play players, or even as pay to play players, to get more tips, being able to grow faster and stuff like that. Share the videos with them, with friends, other guildmates, allies, families. You know who watches Lord Moore's videos. Share them with them. See if they enjoy it. If they do, let them know that they plan to subscribe, and to also take part of these giveaways. So starting off, let me show the other screen. So these are the giveaways that I have planned so far, with as much information as I think I can provide. So starting off, I want to start with a 200 subscriber giveaway. I hope I reach it by Thursday. If I do not reach it by Thursday, I will have to change the event for it. And by event, I mean what I'm going to be doing to do the giveaways. So for a 200 subscriber giveaway, I want to do a stream for it, but to open in the lab, the holy stars, you know, and lab. But I want for it to be, but even for this to happen, I need to reach 200 subscribers before Thursday, and I'll be able to do the stream on Thursday. The time for that stream will be around 5 to 6 p.m. Eastern time. No, 5 to 6 p.m. Central time, I bet, which is about 6 to 7 Eastern time. And from there, you can see whatever time zone it is for you guys, and that's your original subscribers by that day. I'll be doing that stream, and during that stream I'm gonna be doing two 10,000 gem giveaways, and I'll be going over the rules for it, but I'll be giving more details on the stream giveaways of what you need to do in order to be able to win the giveaway. And for one thing, you have to be active in the chat. Then I do have other giveaways planned for 300 400, as you can see on the left side, what sub milestone I want, and what kind of giveaway to do during that time. So at 200 subs, as you can see, I want to do two 10k gem giveaways. At 300, I'm gonna do 30,000 gem giveaway, which is 3 10k. At 400 is gonna be 4 10k. At 500 is gonna be 5 10k. After 500, after 500, I plan to do still 50k for 600-700, because I don't really spend too much to be able to make that many gems. Because I did the math and I would need about 440,000 gems, I believe. I could be off by a little bit. And as you saw earlier, I'm barely close to 300,000, but I should be able to reach 400,000 by the time I reach 1,000 subscribers. Unless you guys just go overboard and really, really impress me, and by giving me 1,000 subscribers like within a month of this video, which then it'll be very difficult for me to make the gems, but it'll be a fun struggle for you guys to watch, you know. And for the 300, 400, 600, 700, 800, and 900 subscribers milestones, I want to do them in a YouTube video of sorts. This video will be, you know, the usual one where you have to leave a comment. Only one comment, no repetitive comments, or not. You won't be able to get extra entries, and you'll be automatically taken out of the auto, the comment gen, not generator, the comment picker. And from there, I'll be doing the video, and then I'll be doing the. I'll give a. I'll, in those videos, I'll be saying how many days will pass before I do the actual pick for the winners. And every video is gonna have its own separate detail for it, because every milestone, it has to be a little different. Can't be the same giveaway over and over again. Though the gems will be the same, and well, as posted here, after at 800,000, 800 subscribers, I'm planning to do a 75,000 gem giveaway, which is 3 winners of 25,000, and then it's gonna go up to 3 winner to on the very last stream at 1,000 subscribers. I'll be doing an account giveaway and 100,000 gems total giveaway, which is 520K winners. And to win that one, they'll be doing the stream. I'll be reviewing that account right now, showing you what it has. I'll be working on it as time goes on. As we get to 1,000 subscribers, I'll keep working on that account, bringing it up, because I haven't been on it for a while, and I'll show you how long I haven't been on it. But basically, I want to show you the rules that I've made so far. Now, these rules could be something to change, but I don't think so. I think I could be adding more rules, but I'll be covering those in future videos and stuff like that. So pretty much, rule number one, to win the gem prizes, you need to be smarter mind than me, because I cannot give to people that are higher mind. And the way to you give in game, you will check out the my account. In order to gift someone in game, I will need to be able to first go to your guild. Be able to see your might be lower than mine, 705. But if I were to go to my guild and show you my ranking, when someone is higher might than me, and I tried gifting them something, so I'm currently 700 million right here. Evo is 1.4 million, but a billion. If I were to try to gift them, it would tell me you can only give to guildmates that are lower might than you, as you can see that. So you have to be lower might than me. You have it to be higher than might than me, but you have an alternate account that you know that you want to improve on it, or you have a close friend that could use the gems, or someone that you know that's starting out that you want to give them the gems. You can let me know, but of course you first have to verify that you are bigger might than me from that account. So going back to the display. So that's the reason for gifting, that you have to be lower mind than me. Of course, yeah, if you happen to be bigger, like I mentioned, you have to give me another account for me to give it to, whether it be an alternate account or a friend account, you let me know, or guildmate, your choice. For the instructions of each giveaway, they will be released on the video prior to each milestone. So like this one, you consider the video for the 198 subscriber giveaway. Now for the 200 subscriber giveaway, which is gonna be, and right now is before I can reach 200 subscribers, and I'll be telling you that I do plan to do the stream, and during the stream, it's gonna be those giveaways. And of course, the details for those giveaways will be announced during stream, as you can see right here on rule number three. For stream gem giveaways, you need to be present on stream to participate and claim the gems if you win. Details on how to join the stream giveaways will be announced on stream at the time of the giveaway. So on any moment during stream, I'll say at what point I'm gonna be doing the giveaway, and during that point of the giveaway, I'll be saying what you need to do to enroll into the giveaway. Now of course for the videos, because there's gonna be video giveaways where you have to leave a comment on the video and then respond. There's certain for those videos, I'll be. You'll be leaving a comment I was saying we're going to leave a comment out. It could either be guild, might, you know, the usual, or it could be a random word that you need to watch the video in order to like actually know what word it is. Or it could, but once whatever it could be. But after I post the video, I will give a certain time frame for you to be able to join the event. And after the time frame finishes, I'll be doing a stream. Whether it be 2 days, 5 days after the video is released, I'll be doing a live stream where I'll be doing something, whether it be upgrading gear, opening chests that I saved up, just talking, showing a rally party, whatever it might be. It depends what I have available for me at that moment. But I'll be showing, no, I'll be doing on live stream. I will also be using the comment picker to pick the winners, and those winners will have a total of 48 hours after the stream in order to to contact me and saying what they want as a part of the reward. Because when you win gems on giveaways, we can only give you a gem value equivalent. So if I tell you win 10,000 gems, I cannot give you the 10,000 gems. I will have to give you 10,000 gems worth of resources, worth of speed ups, worth of relocators, worth of shields. But yeah, but it has to be to the gem value, to the gem store value. Because that's pretty much what the gifting is. And so I've talked a little too much. I'm around to 11 minutes in this current recording, and I haven't even gone over the count that I'm giving away. So at 1,000 subscribers, the account giveaway that I'm gonna be giving away is gonna be during stream. I hope I'm able to get enough viewers on stream, but if my live viewers on stream happens to be a very low number, I will have to be change it into a video giveaway. But that depends on, you know, how many people are watching on stream. But if we go to the other account, let me open it up over here. Right here, can you open, please? Thank you. You're not opening. Why is this not opening? Okay, there we go. So this is a wood hyper I was working on back in the day, which due to how busy my schedule became, I had to let it go, and I think I wasn't able to work too much more on it. But right now I started working back on it. It already has 126,000 gems because I never use the gems up on this account. So you can use them at any moment that you want for whoever is the winner. Right here, as you can see, it's a wood hyper. At the moment, it does have all production boosts, which is the production boost. This is the current production boost gear it has. It's not the best, since for wood hypers, the production gear is very expensive when it comes to actually the gear parts. There's no free-to-play piece for that. But it does have almost what is this, 14 lumber mills. It has a building here that can help your guild out and send help guild fest quests. So you can use, yeah, that's the reason that farm existed there, in order to be able to produce the help spam. Right now I have it in the guild DF Carrot. Well, Carrot, because that's the name of that symbol. In Kingdom 624, they're really helping me out right now, helping me build the guild coins up, so it's gonna ha so it can have migration scrolls for whoever wins it. They'll be able to take it to their kingdom. It currently has no troops because I have not bothered reviving them. It only has 34,000, which were all part tier 3, part tier 4, mostly tier 1, because I only use them as gatherers due to being a wood hyper. It does have two barracks, which is something I regret doing now because I know that's not an efficient way of doing it. The building wise, for pay-to-play buildings, you do have some materials, but not too many to be able to upgrade it even more. As you can see, I already did battle hall the most I could to level 14. I have not been able to do an altar yet, but if I were to be able to do an altar, it has 338. It's not that many, but it's somewhat of a start. We're looking at familiar wise. As you can see, this was before I learned everything I needed to do for familiars and everything I taught myself, which I will be changing this as time goes on. I will be training more familiars. I'll be working on them. I'll be boosting them up. And as you can see, I do have several packs already saved up that I hadn't opened before. But Tyrite is already at level 58, who has the ability for merging speed to be at level 7, and the Netherquake being at level 5. We thus have the Oak Root, which is for root production, at level 9, which means it's already maxed out for what I can get it to at the moment. Right now I'm working on Aquarius to get the refreshed skill, to get it more stamina, to be able to get more the heroes up faster, and as well as Soul Tempest in order to get also the higher wood production. Now the reason I said I cannot get him maxed out yet is because, as you can see, right now it's level 58, the player level, but I should be able to get it to level 59 at least by the time of the giveaway. As you can see, I do have some stuff saved up, and Guildfist should be coming up next week, I believe, or the following week. And I don't think I'll reach 1,000 subscribers by then, but if I do, that'll be insanely amazing. I really appreciate it, guys. But as you can see, I should still have enough time to bring this account up. I'll be building it up to be a fully maxed out wood hyper. I'll do my best not to use the speed ups that the account has. I'll be fixing up the buildings to have a more efficient production of familiars, as well as a more efficient wood production. Research-wise, economy, it has the wood production maxed out already. The other ones are kind of touched, not too much. Defense-wise, it had a little bit work on it before I stopped working on defense because I figured it was useless. For military, it does have quite a bit of levels on military to all the way to 6 and 7, which is the bare minimum requirements to unlock tier 3, but I never got around to unlocking tier 3 because I didn't want to spend too much time on that. Monster hunting, it has enough max out for CS 20, for Academy 24 all the way until Monster Hunt 3. From there you can see where I kind of left off, and monster hunting level 4 is not unlocked yet. Then we have upgrade defense. Again, I worked a little bit on it just for hell events, and that's it. Upgrade military, I upgraded enough to finish the subsidies for 1 and 2, for tier 1 and tier 2. Tier 2 is almost maxed out. I could work on that too. And I have enough to start unlocking back expansion, inner talent, and training speed. For upgrade military, I have this worked up a bit, only to be able to send more marches, bigger marches, to be able to send more resources out per march. For military command, it's just a little bit worked on it, just to get some extra stamina, shelter time, but mainly stamina. This is the main thing I'm working on this stream. But following that, familiars, right now I'm working on the familiars to be able to unlock Timber Harvesting 9, which is the last one I can get for fully free to play without having to grind out to Academy 25. And that will also increase, this is the last research, and then I'm going to do this research before I can actually finish Timber Harvesting 2. For familiar battles, I only unlock the slot. Siege is not touched at all, and War Tone, Wonder Battle is not touched at all. And of course, Academy 25 not reached yet. Not covering all gear, because I still need to upgrade those buildings. I have some gear saved up. I was able to get lucky with this piece. Actually, I did not equip this piece. Let's see what the wood production is actually with that piece equipped. So our wood production is at 2.4 million wood per hour, which is honestly a pretty good amount for being a super dead account, which was not worked on properly, and having a lot of lumber bills 24. But let's see, I do have other pieces of gear built up, familiar gear kind of worked on to be able to help perform better when merging familiars. We have some other random pieces. As you can see, I have the third squirrel ready for whenever I get the armory to level 25 to be able to equip it. I have some speed gear. I have some starter war gear, which is what I was kind of working on. This would be a trap account before I gave up on it and just zeroed it myself. As you can see, it's not that much of great gear, but I'll work on gathering in a moment to be able to pick up that gear up even more. You might be able to get the account with gold war gear, gold free to play war gear, by the time you get to you. As for resources in bag, it has quite a bit. It doesn't have too much. It's not a very impressive number. It has almost 300 million food, 66 million stone, 137 million wood, 92 million ore, and 84 million gold at the moment in bags. It's building wise, I have 23 and 22 on manors. This I mainly did this to start training faster and as well as produce more gold. I will hopefully have this maxed out too, so it can be a gold hyper as well in case you want to do that instead of being a wood hyper on the account. Other than that, I think that's pretty much everything you would want to know about the castle. It has no castle skins. It's just one castle star on the castle itself. We go to unique. You have some brave hearts. You have some food for XP on the heroes. Right now it has some relocators, 10 resets. As you can see, the special equipment. That's a little bit of these squirrels, but I might use them for guild fest. Who knows? That's quite a bit of energy saved up. As you can see, 82 of the 1,000, 54 of the 2,000, 10 of the 5,000, 1, 10,000, 18, 20,000, and 7, 50,000. Of course, the 50,000 is a little overkill at the moment because at the moment it only fits 24,000 energy. That's the reason I have not used these ones at all. I do have EXP boost and 17.50% monster hunt attack, so that I have saved up over Guildfest. And you can use them in the future. I do have some holy stars saved up on this account, but I might not use them. I might just keep saving them up and hopefully unlock Trickstar as well to help out. I do have some anima saved up, not too much. 116 archaic tomes, one and one token. But we're going to resources. Speed ups, it does have a bit of speed up saved up, as you can see, in several hundreds on all of them. And then 10 24 hour speed ups as well. We have some boost saved up from events. We have gathering speed boost. A lot of I'm gonna be using this one in a bit to be able to gather a lot faster and a lot more. I have some, it does have some boots saved up. This might go up as I do more events on this account. Next we have research speed ups. Also have several couple hundred on each of them, 1 to 3 hour speed ups. Then at 8 hours, 45 7 of 15 hours, 124 and three days. It does have one mystic carpet from when the first bargain store came out. As wall repairs, which don't really matter. It does have some healing speed ups. It has a good amount of training speed ups saved up. These are the speed ups saved up from maintenances that have come out. There's 2 day speed ups for in the future when you're producing more. It has a good amount of merging speed ups as well as merging boosts. For combat, it has a decent amount of 4 hour shields and 8 hour shields. At the moment, I might be using up all of these 3 days and 24 hour shields, but I might be gifting it more from my main account once I'm able to move it over in order to be able to help it out even more. It does have some anti-scout saved up. It does have 650% army attack boost saved up from Guildfest and from high level DNs that I used to run on it. Well, I used to join with this account that was run by my main account. Chest wise, it has 89 jewel chests actually, so you can actually work. I'm gonna allow you guys to have this. I might be able to get this to 100 chests by the time I give it away, just to help out whoever wants to build some war gear on it in the future, whoever the winner is. Monster chest is not too many chests that are saved up, just some sprinkles here and there. And it does have the legendary mystic eggs when they first came out, which was a year or two ago during Easter. So you can open these up in order to be able to get more gold or more chests. And I'll be competing and I'll be entering into different events with this account. Right now it only has 433,000 guild points, but I'm planning on working that number up in order to be able to, or whoever wants it, to be able to purchase a migration scroll on it to be able to move it anywhere. Right now it's a small account. I'll be working on it and I'll show progress at the 500 subscriber stream, because I do plan to do a stream during that time. And we go back over here, we go to display. As you can see, I don't know what I'm gonna be doing on that stream yet. I'm gonna be just doing a stream working the account, showing how far the account is, unless there's a rally party or something during that day, whatever day might show up. I might be able to show those, any random rallies that come out. anything in general. And as you can see, the question marks, is they are subject to change depending on what I could have during those times. Like, if a friend of mine wants for me to open their Material Madness on stream, I'll be doing the stream instead of a video of a. I'll be doing that stream when doing the giveaways and stuff like that. Now, I hope you found this video helpful and you'll be able to actually participate in these giveaways and help me out. Share the video with any of your friends. And if you made it this far into the video, you are the real MVP right here. And if you did make it this far, leave a comment down below saying, what are we gonna say? We're gonna say Trickster, you know, the hero. You can leave them down in the comments. Trickster is the best. I want to see how many people actually reach the very end and leave that comment down below. And then we'll see how many people react to that comment and be like, what do you mean? And then just put like, watch the whole video as a reply. Just to see how many people actually watch our videos. But thank you. That'll be it for today. And I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.